with only a few minutes left, let's jump into the topic of interactive visualization. And interactive visualization is nice because it's possible in stuff like our Jupyter notebooks, and because it's really nice because we don't have to rerun the same cell over and over, hitting shift and enter when simply changing a few input parameters. So that's really nice. And also, if there are readers, for example, your supervisor or somebody who wants to look into your data in detail, they can simply zoom in instead of having to add their own code. So we also look at interactive visualization here, and we're going to start real quick with Plotly. Plotly is a nice interactive visualization library for Python that's not built on top of Matplotlib, so replaced it. It's meant for enterprise customers, and it wants always to use this Plotly Chart Studio Cloud, where it automatically, so you have to connect to your Plotly account, and it automatically puts your plot onto this Chart Studio Cloud. I really don't know why it does that. It's probably useful for some enterprise customers. I don't know, my bosses wouldn't have liked that wherever. So never mind, automatically stores your plots online if you have an account. However, you can use it without the online constraint, even though it annoys you sometimes. But what it does, it automatically creates interactable plots as HTML, and that's really, really nice because we can simply, well, we can put these plots on our website. We can make, for example, if we make, if we upload this Jupyter notebook to GitHub, we can simply have these plots as HTML in there, and it simply works. And also, thanks to nice JupyterLab extensions, these plots can be rendered in JupyterLab. So make sure that you have installed these JupyterLab extensions. So how Plotly is displayed changed in JupyterLab 2.0. So if you did explain the debugger, then I made it part of the new installation instructions. If you didn't, you have to install this lab extension here. And you also may have to look that you want to update Plotly, because there was a nice feature that was added to Plotly literally 2 weeks ago. So let's look real quick, just two or three plots for Plotly. Let's look real quick. How do we plot in Plotly? Well, we create the graph object as GO here. Then we create a Plotly figure, not a matplotlib figure here. And then we want to add two things. We're using the method figure.addTrace. First, we want a scatter plot, which is this thing here, and we see nice interactive visualization. And second of all, we want a bar plot. And then we have to update the layer, for example, setting the title here. This is a standard example which Plotly has on their website. And then we can simply call figure.show. And this here gives me this nice plot, and I can zoom in on stuff, and it's automatically interactive. I mean, it's not really useful for this kind of plot because it's a bar plot, but it's possible and it's done really quick. And like I said, it automatically creates HTML. So I can simply call figure.write.html. And if I also auto open this, I can open this as HTML. And now I have this first figure.html here. And even this is a normal HTML website, I can upload that to any web server, and it still has the functionalities which I had in JupyterLab. So I can look at the page source of this, and this is what Plotly made. So it automatically made a JavaScript that renders this plot. All right. Because I also don't know Plotly too well, I don't want to go into too much detail. Just again here, I have to make sure that I download, that I import stuff from plotly.offline, because otherwise it wants to sell me its cloud. And here again, this is other sample calls I simply copied from the Plotly website and made work here. So standard Plotly calls look like this. Why do I import it again here? So these are two different scatter plots on the same figure. So I can simply say, give me a figure using this data. So the data here is the go.scatter with so two go scatters as a list, and then the layer, and then I can specify the title with height, x-axis description, y-axis description, etc., etc. So this is how Plotly plots. It doesn't base on matplotlib, so it's different. All the calls are different, but it is a nice library all in all, I think. And what Plotly can do, and that is that it can replace Pandas plot backend. So since Pandas 1.0, kind of recent version, Pandas allowed that the dot plot backend. So normally when Pandas use calls dot plot, it simply automatically calls a matplotlib plot, which where it sets the variables accordingly using the data frame. But we can replace that if we have Plotly 4.8, which is a version which is less than 2 weeks old. So make sure you have this very new version of Plotly. And then what we can do is we can set, again, this also requires Pandas 1.0, but you should have it. Then we can set pandas.options.plotting.backend equals Plotly. And then if I now call, for example, titanic.plot, it makes a Plotly plot out of this, where we have the standard Plotly features. So it's not a drop-in replacement because it doesn't support all the keyword arguments. It does support these ones here, for example, so kind, x, and y. Of course it does, because those are the basic ones. And it obviously looks a lot different. But yeah, you can rechange your plotting backend. One second, I forgot how to reset it back. Okay, so Pandas provides the reset option. So I can simply call pandas.resetOption, and then I can provide it plotting.backend. And now if I plot, it takes forever, but it does return subplots.axis, sorry, matplotlib axis subplot object again. But it looks shitty in matplotlib. So this, we can do this in Plotly, because how Plotly knows what kind, so Plotly knows what kind of data it can plot, and can plot data differently than matplotlib. And this kind of plot looks shitty in matplotlib. But we could change, for example, that we don't want a bar plot, and then it would create a rather useless plot, but it would be faster. So again, how you can plot depends on your backend. And I have provided the link on how to plot Pandas data frames using Plotly here. So this is from May 26. That's when they updated to 4.8, where they accept more different kinds of Pandas data frames to plot, not just this tidy long format. And that's after that they started to be able to replace these the plotting backend for Pandas. So I already showed you this picture. So this here is a wide data frame and this is a long data frame. If you want to have more details about how to do that, I can only recommend to watch last year's lecture about tidy data, because this here is so-called tidy data, where there are no variables in the respective, so only one variable per column, etc., etc. So this here is how to nicer have it, and while the standard backend can only plot tidy data, and this data is not really tidy, Plotly can plot it nicely because it also accepts this wide form of data. So you can look at this description or last lecture if you want to have more details, but you just know you can replace matplotlib entirely even using Pandas plot function method. Okay, and then again, I have the example gallery. So these here are the kinds of plots you can do with Plotly. If one of these suits your need, I recommend to use Plotly. If not, I recommend not to use Plotly, especially because it's a complete change from matplotlib and you can customize it easily, etc., etc.